The following video tutorial is in addition to our widely popular instructional DVD, Installing and Replacing Toilets. Be sure to watch both part 1 and part 2 to get the full benefit of the tutorial. Start to finish with a pro, find it all at Trades Video. One of the most common problems we encounter on a daily basis is a broken PVC closet flange. If you look down at this one here, you can see that where you lock your closet bolt has busted off. Now the reason this flange broke, this is a 4x3 closet flange. It's glued inside of a 4-inch riser pipe. Well, that pipe is coming up through the floor crooked. So when they glued the flange down, they could get it tight down to the floor on this side, but they've got a 1/4-inch space on this side. That tells me that the pipe's coming up through crooked. If you can't get your flange flat down on the floor, then you're gonna have stress that's gonna break the flange eventually. So we're gonna show you how to replace this broken PVC closet flange, which is inserted inside the 4-inch pipe. Now this is 4-inch PVC pipe. This is the pipe we have coming up through this floor. You may find when you pull your toilet that your flange is glued on the outside of the pipe. It's glued on to the outside. Now, if that's the case and it's broken, all you have to do is break the flange portion off, make sure that you cut that pipe flush with your finished floor, and then you can go back in with the 4x3, which will go inside the 4-inch pipe. So if your flange is broken, it's glued on the outside of the pipe, no problem. At least you've got good pipe inside. You can break that off with a hammer or chisel, whatever. Just be careful. Do not break the pipe. You need that pipe to be in good condition to replace the flange. Now, I've got a few different options, different ways that I can replace this flange. Again, it's glued inside the pipe. So the object is to remove that fitting without damaging the internal wall of the pipe. Now, I've stuffed some rags down in there. Now one option, first of all, you want to break the top off. And one of the easiest ways to do that is to take a carpenter's chisel, a good sharp carpenter's chisel, and just bang it on that PVC and work your way around the flange until you break the top of it off. That sharp chisel will cut through that plastic and break it off. Be careful not to damage the inside of the pipe. Now, to get the actual fitting out of the pipe, one option is to take a jab saw and cut a line through the fitting only. Stop when you get to the pipe. And then move over about 1 inch or 3/4 and score another line through the fitting only. Stop when you get to the pipe. And then take a good sharp chisel, get it between the wall of the pipe and the wall of the fitting, and try to knock that piece of plastic that you have cut on both sides of. Now you may have to repeat that around the pipe. One thing that I found is if the plumber that installed this, if he used primer and cleaner first and then he glued it in, it's almost impossible to separate it from the pipe because it is a solvent weld joint. You've welded two pieces of plastic together. But a lot of times, this is not part of an inspection phase. So the plumber may have just glued it in there. If that's the case, you're in luck. Because when you drive that chisel down between the pipe and the fitting, it's gonna pop right off. But if he did use a primer, you're gonna have a problem. Now, I've done hundreds of these. My option, which you really have to be pretty careful, and you have to have done it a number of times, but I'll take my variable speed cordless drill. and I'll put a 4-inch hole saw in it. Now I know that the inside diameter of 4-inch pipe is going to be almost exactly the same size as my 4-inch hole saw. But I have no guide to keep it centered. So I kind of have to do that freehand. But I've got that variable speed. I can control the speed. So if I'm wavering off center, I can make adjustments. But what I'll do is I'll set that saw right in the center of the flange, inside that bevel, and then just cut nice and slowly. And I'll check my cut, see how I look for center. Now I know the pipe is coming up at a bit of an angle, so I'm gonna make adjustments for that. The goal is just to get that fitting out of the inside of the pipe. So I'll work it a little at a time. I'm not gonna go crazy with it. I'm gonna play with it and make adjustments as I go. Now it would have been a big help if I brought my side handle that screws into the side of the drill, but we'll just have to make do with what we have for now. Okay, now I've gotten the flange part off, but I've still got the pipe or the fitting inside the pipe. And I look like I might be running a little bit off center. So let me make some adjustments for that. All right, I've gotten down in there deep enough. Now I'm gonna go ahead and just make two score cuts to see if I can pop the rest of that fitting off so that I don't have to force my drill all the way down in there and run the risk of cracking the 4-inch pipe coming up through the floor. I'll make one cut there. I don't want to go any deeper than the fitting. And then I'll come over here a little ways, make another cut. Getting pretty close to it. My saw is binding on the soft molten plastic. It kind of heats up the plastic and softens it, and it binds up your saw. All right, let's see if we can take a good sharp wood chisel and separate the fitting from the pipe. See how that piece just popped right off of there? See, that tells me that the plumber did not prime it. He used glue only. So now that I've got it loose, I wouldn't doubt if that whole thing will pop right off for me. Be careful, you don't wanna damage the pipe. As long as the pipe stays intact, you'll be able to get your replacement flange in there, no problem.